So today we are going to review lymphedema bandaging for the leg. So we have all the materials laid out here. Some of these materials may vary depending on your therapist's recommendation. So we have some shorter pieces of tape cut out, then we also have some longer pieces of tape. We also have a stockinette, which will be applied to the leg first. We have a small bandage, which will be wrapped around the toes. We have cotton, which will be wrapped around the foot and the ankle. We also have the foam padding, which will be wrapped up the leg. We have the kidneys, which will be placed below the ankle on both sides. Then we have the bandages. So we have a 6 centimeter, 2 8-centimeters, and a 10 centimeter bandage. We also have Coban, which will be used to secure the bandages in place. So before you begin applying the bandages, you want to make sure that your leg is washed and lotioned. First, we're going to apply the stockinette. You want it to go up just above where the bandages will end. Today we are going to show you how to apply bandages just below the knee. So first off, we're going to begin with a small bandage. You want to begin with rolling it in a snail-like pattern. Go once around the foot, and then you're going to begin with the big toe. You want to wrap around a few times, and then you're going to make an X-like pattern as you cross back over, and then go around the foot one more time and begin the next toe. You're going to do this for all the toes except for the small toe, making sure that after you wrap the toe, you have the X-like pattern. So then you can begin the next toe. And you want to make sure that the bandage ends just below the toenail. And you can always rewrap the toe as needed. Make sure that you make the X-like pattern. And then just remember not to wrap the small toe. And then you can always tuck in that last piece to secure the bandage. So next, we're going to take the cotton and start wrapping it around the foot. You're going to work your way up towards the ankle. And then you're going to apply the kidneys with the rounded shape, touching the skin. These go just below the ankle bone. And then you want to make sure that you cover them with the cotton to hold them in place. So next we're going to apply the foam padding, and we're going to start at about the ankle crease, just below it, and you're going to wrap this up the leg. You want to make sure that you secure the first wrap, and then you're going to go up at about a 50% overlap in between. And you're going to continue wrapping up until just below the kneecap. And then if you have extra, you can go ahead and cut the rest off and use one of the small pieces of tape to secure it down. So you're going to go ahead and bend your leg to make sure that movement is still available. Next, we're going to start applying the bandage. So we're going to take the 6 centimeter bandage, start wrapping around the foot. We're going to wrap around it 3 times, making sure that your toes are pointed up towards the ceiling. You can go ahead and smooth out the bandages as you go. Then you're going to wrap around the back of the ankle and then go back down to the foot, making an X-like pattern. You're going to do this 3 times. And you want to apply some tension as you're applying this bandage. If you have extra, you can go ahead and wrap it up the leg. And then you're going to use a small piece of tape to secure it down. So next, you're going to want to move your ankle up and down a few times. This makes sure that you're still allowed to move your ankle and that it's not restricted. So you want to go ahead and make sure your toes are pointed up for the ceiling with the second bandage. I'm going to start at the ankle, make sure it's secured. Then you're going to go down to the heel. Then go back and wrap around the ankle. Then you want to go down towards the sole of your foot, making sure to wrap any cotton that's visible. Then you're going to go around the heel, back around the ankle, and then again to the sole of the foot. If you have any extra, you can go ahead and wrap it up the leg. With this bandage, you want to make sure that all the cotton is not visible. Go ahead and use one of the small pieces of tape to secure it down. And then you want to make sure that you pump your ankle a few times. Okay. So then we're going to apply the next bandage. Make sure your toes are still facing up towards the ceiling. You're going to start at the ankle, secure the first one around. Then you're going to go up the leg at the 50% overlap. And you want to continue this up the leg. You want to go up to the top of the foam. And if you have any extra bandage, you can go ahead and loosely roll it down the leg and then secure it with a small piece of tape. So then again, go ahead and pump your ankle up and down a few times. So now we're ready for the last bandage. So with the toes pointing up towards the ceiling, we're going to apply the first wrap around the ankle. And then you're going to apply tension as you go with the 50% overlap with this bandage too. Smoothing it out as you go helps to create even greater compression. So again, continue it all the way up to the top of where the foam ends. And if there's any extra, go ahead and just gently roll it down with no tension. Since this is our last bandage, we'll use the long pieces of tape to secure it down. Want to make sure that the bandage doesn't become loose and start to unravel. You can go ahead and roll down the rest of the stockinette to help hold the bandages in place. And then you can apply Coband to the top to help hold the bandages in place even more. And then you're going to want to make sure that you have either a medical shoe or anti-slip socks at home to wear for safety when walking around. So then you can go ahead and gently press the toes to make sure that there's circulation. If there's numbness in the toes, you'll want to unwrap the bandages and reapply them, because this could be a sign of poor circulation. So again, that's just a review of how to apply bandages to the leg for lymphedema treatment.